Hi, welcome to the Reclaim Me channel, and today the topic is FAT file system. FAT is the oldest file system which is still widely used. FAT stands for File Allocation Table, the main file system structure. There are many versions of FAT file system which mainly differ in the number of bits. The fact is that the developers of that time could not predict how rapidly storage devices would evolve, and they increased the number of bits a little bit. But 3 years later, they had to increase the number of bits again. That's why there are so many FAT versions. The following FAT versions existed historically. FAT 8 used 8 bits, FAT 12 used 12 bits, FAT 16 used 16 bits, FAT 32 used 28 bits, and extended FAT uses 32 bits. As I have already said, the difference between FAT 8, 12, 16 and 32 lies in the number of bits, while extended FAT uses the different format of directories. FAT cuts a disk space into clusters, and the number of bits determines how many clusters can be on the volume. Since the maximum size of a cluster is limited in size, the number of bits determines the maximum size of the volume. Additionally, since a file occupies at least one cluster, the number of bits determines how many files can be stored on the volume. As requirements to storage devices grew, the developers had to increase the number of bits. As for inner FAT structure, all FAT versions create the volume in about the same way. Let's illustrate. We have a physical disk. In the beginning, boot sectors go. Then there are one or several FAT tables. And then the data area divided into clusters. It can be one or two boot sectors depending on FAT versions, and it can be one or several, typically two, but up to four FAT tables. Root directory is usually stored in the first cluster on the data area. All file system elements, boot sectors, FAT tables, and the data area are stored either continuously or with some gaps. For example, in extended FAT, there may be empty space between FAT tables and the data area to ensure the proper alignment on USB thumb drives. Boot sectors store the main information about file system, cluster size, and the FAT table location and size. FAT tables store the location of files on the data area. And the directories store file names, sizes, date and time of file creation, and the numbers of the first clusters. If the directory element is known, the file size and the number of the first cluster can be taken from it. If a file occupies less than one cluster, it is enough to read this cluster. If a file occupies more than one cluster, the numbers of second and subsequent clusters can be taken from FAT tables. For each cluster, FAT table stores either the number of subsequent cluster or the sign that this is the end of the file, or zero if this is a free cluster. Let's look more closely at read operation on FAT file system. Imagine that we need to read text file ABC. First, the file system goes to a directory and knows that the beginning of the file is stored in cluster 3. A file system reads cluster 3. Then a file system goes to element 3 of a table and finds out that the next part of the file is stored in cluster 4. Reads cluster 4. Fourth element says that the next part of the file is stored in cluster 6. A file system reads cluster 6. But when a file system reads element 6, it sees EOF, meaning the end of the file. Thus, data is taken from clusters while the next cluster is taken from FAT table. Since metadata is stored in different places, is updated independently, and is synchronized not as good as we would like, sometimes some contradictions may happen. For example, a directory may point to a free cluster, cluster chains may form loops, a directory may link to the middle of a chain, or two chains may have common tail, and so on. In data recovery, these cases are solved differently. Additionally, different data recovery tools use different algorithms for each case. A directory is stored in the same way as a typical file and is marked with a special attribute. Originally, there were no directories in FAT and they were implemented sometime later. Additionally, in 1995, the format of the element was expanded and now there are two versions of a directory entry. Within the old format, a directory entry contains 8 symbols for file name and 3 symbols for file extension. This is called 8-3 standard. File names shorter than 8 symbols are padded with spaces up to 8. File names longer than 8 symbols are not allowed. Additionally, a directory entry contains file size, the number of the first cluster, the date and time of file creation, and attributes. To write file names longer than 8 symbols, another format allowing 13 symbols per element was developed. Thus, a file in a directory is described one element of old format, holding information about file content location, file size, and short file name, and elements of new format, the number of which is determined by the long file name. By the way, the element is 32 bytes in size. Thus, a directory entry stores two file names, a long file name and short file name for each file, and these names can be different. Now let's look at file deletion on FAT file system, taking our file ABC as an example. When you delete the file, first its records in FAT table are zeroed. Secondly, in a corresponding directory entry, first bytes of all elements are replaced with E5. In element of the old format, where 8.3 standard is used, the first symbol of a file name is destroyed. In the elements of the new format, storing long file names, the number of element is destroyed, which is not that significant. As you can see, file deletion does not cause much damage to a directory entry. In the worst case, the first symbol of short file name is lost, but you can easily recover it from the long file name. Much worse is that FAT table is zeroed and you can no longer find next clusters for a file. And the best assumption you can make in this case is that the file was not fragmented and its clusters are stored contiguously on a disk. If this is not so, the file cannot be recovered. For example, in our case, there is no way to know that the cluster, the correct cluster chain was 3, 4 and 6. Therefore, our file cannot be recovered. Directories can be found by their beginnings. While technically there is no header in a directory, the first element always has name dot and describes the directory itself. The second element has name dot dot and describes the root directory, the parent directory. You can find beginnings of all FAT directories by searching disk for dot and 10 spaces in the beginning of a sector. That's all about FAT file system. You can find more information in our book Logical Data Recovery. If you like our videos, subscribe to the Reclaim Me channel. Reclaim Me team was with you. See you soon!